Just note down the numbers of the circuit and that's it. In less than 3 seconds we have all the compatible models. I have some of these models in our workshop. Ideally a new circuit should be placed, but as the client is in a hurry, I'm going to put one of ours. Changing an integrated circuit like the Pmic or the IF Pmic can take less than 10 minutes. We have repaired thousands and thousands of devices over the last few years with these tricks. We leave the failures in the CPU and memories for people who have a certain level. To reball this circuit, first of all, we solder at 350 Celsius degrees to remove the excess solder lead. Then we use an economical stencil. For this process, we have used 180 Celsius degrees solder paste with lead. On our YouTube channel, you can find a lot of video with this process with many details. You just have to write on YouTube Mobil 1 reballing and you'll find videos to entertain you for a good while. After the reballing process, we'll apply a little bit of flux and we heat the component for 5 to 6 seconds at 350 Celsius degrees to make sure all the balls are even. Here is another trick. When there is a gap between two balls, practically the paint has been lost. If you don't want to have problems when you are soldering the circuit, you should apply a UV mask and cure it. In this way, there is no risk of the balls bonding underneath when you are soldering the circuit. To cure the UV mask, you can use an ultraviolet flashlight from AliExpress, which is very economical. Now it's time to solder the circuit, so first we apply a thin layer of flux to improve the micro-soldering. To solder it, a temperature of 380 Celsius degrees and the air flow of 30% is recommended. If it's a larger circuit, we should increase the air flow by 10%. Finally, to ensure a good cleaning, it's advisable to clean the area with the contact cleaner or isopropyl alcohol.